Hello everyone, in this video we are going to look at a possible solution for first readeritis problem using semaphore and mutex using the C programming language. So I have already discussed what is readeritis problem and also a solution to it, but I have not discussed the solution in C programming. I just discussed a pseudocode solution in my previous video. So first let's go through what is readeritis problem. So, this definition is taken from a famous book on operating system by Galvin. So, suppose that you have a database that is to be shared among concurrent processes. Now, some of the processes, just want to read from the database, and there are some other processes which want to both read and write, that is modify the database. Now, one type of process is called reader. So reader is that process that only wants to read from the database, and there is other processes which are writers, right? So they are the ones who wants to update the database. So that's what the reader, so those are the readers and writers in this problem. Now how if two readers access their data simultaneously, no adverse effects will result, because reading does not modify the data, right? So you won't have any adverse effects. But if a writer and some other process, it can be either reader or a writer, tries to access a database concurrently, then some issues may happen. So you would know about the race condition, right? So let's say there is a data that is shared between multiple processes, right? And if both are multiple processes are trying to update that same data at the same time, then race condition can happen. Now, to ensure that these difficulties do not arise, we require that writers have exclusion access to the shared database while adding database. That means when a writer is modifying the data, then there should be no other writer modifying that, and also there should not be also any readers present which is reading that data. So this synchronization problem is referred to as the reader-writer problem. So you understood the problem here, right? What is the problem, right? So if two writers are trying to modify this same data at the same time, then issues can happen. And also if a reader and a writer both are trying to access this at the same time, again issues can happen. So this is the problem here. Now there are several variations of this problem. The simplest one, referred to as the first reader-writer's problem, requires that no reader be kept waiting unless a writer has already obtained permission to use the shared object. So if I have to simplify this, in the first reader-writer's problem, if there is any reader that is accessing the data, then no writer will be allowed it. If any reader is waiting for reading, then no writer will be allowed it. And in the second reader-writer's problem, if some writer is already waiting, then if some writers are already waiting, then no readers will be allowed it. So both are opposite. So in the first case, what can happen is readers will keep on coming and accessing the data, and writers can stop. And in the second reader is a problem, writers will keep on writing, and readers can starve. Now let's look at a pseudocode. So yeah, this is the video actually I have made explaining this concept, the theory in details. Now let's look at a pseudocode using semaphore and mutex. So we have three important variables here. One is a semaphore write. So this semaphore write is a binary semaphore which will be used for both mutual exclusion and signaling. We'll look at how. Then you have a mutex. So this is a mutex data structure, and this provides only mutual exclusion when read count is being modified. So read count is a shared variable, and whenever we are doing modification to this, then we will use mutex to protect this from concurrent access. And we have also a read count global variable. This is for to keep count of the total readers. So how many total readers are in the queue or are reading. Now writer's code is very simple. So it will just wait on this write semaphore. And this is a binary semaphore, right? So if write equal to 1, it can decrement this and go inside and perform the write operation. And then it will use signal operation so that other writers which are waiting to perform write can then enter. And also if you see here, the write semaphore is also used for mutual exclusion here. It is used for both signaling and mutual exclusion. Signaling in the sense that it is signaling to the other writers that you can enter the critical section, and mutual exclusion in the sense that if one writer is already in the critical section, then others won't be able to enter. Also, reader's code here is a complex, and we should understand this reader's part. So what so let's say the first reader comes in, what it will do is it will first obtain the mutual exclusion lock, mutex lock, because it wants to increment read count plus plus, and this is a shared data between all the readers. So that's why it will first obtain the lock, then increment it. Then if it is the first reader, right? If it is the first reader, then it should block the writer. That's what I told you. This is the first reader's writer problem solution. So if any reader is there, then it will block the writer from writing. So this is the first reader, so it will use the wait operation and block the writer. But two cases can happen. So if the first reader enters here, it will block. But what happens if the writer enters before the first reader, right? Then the writer would have called wait write, right? And write value will be zero and it will enter. And since the writer is already in the critical section, right? When the first reader comes here, it will again do the wait operation, right? And it will be blocked here because since write has already been decremented to zero, now this reader has to wait here because a writer is already here performing write operation. So it will wait, and also other readers will also wait because this mutex is already taken by the first reader, right? So no other readers will be able to obtain this mutex also. So other readers will also keep waiting. When the writer is done here, it will use the signal operation. So this signal operation is for both reader and writer. For writer that, okay, I am done with writing, now you can proceed ahead, right? And for reader also, the first reader also, it's a signal that, okay, writing is done, now you can also go ahead and do the read operation. Now, which of these reader, the first reader, or the writer is successful depends on the process scheduler. So both will try to, the writer will try to enter, obtain this write, will execute this wait, and also the first reader will also execute this at the same time, and then it completely depends on the process scheduler to decide which one will be able to do it this first. And then after the first reader is done with all this, it will give the log back and perform some read operation, and when it is done with the read operation, it will again obtain the log, because it has to decrement this read count, because it has done the reading, it is now exiting this, so it will read count minus minus. And in case, so read count equal to zero means there are no readers waiting, and that simply means that this is the last reader, right? So if this is the last reader and there are no readers, right, because this is the last reader, there are no other readers, it will signal to the writer that okay, since there are no readers here, you can go ahead with the write operation. So that's why signal write here, for signaling the writer that there are no readers here, you can go with the write operation. And finally, it will also give the mutex back. So that is what I explain here in these lines also. And then we'll now look at the C code. So I gave more time to understanding the pseudo code, because the actual C code also is just, I've just modified it to, C programming language. But the logic here is same as discussed in the pseudo code, so you will be able to understand this code easily. And also I've used mutex and semaphore that is provided by the C. So if you want to understand more about what parameters they take, and they are almost equivalent of wait and signal operation, and they will have different names in C. And if you want to understand them better, this is the link I have provided here. You can click on this link and understand that. Now let's just run through the code. In this program I've used 10 readers and 5 It will be 10 readers and 5 writers. Okay, this is a semaphore write, right? Same in the pseudo code. Then you have the mutex. Then you have, this is the count actually. So I've used this global count to the readers and writers will be accessing this variable. And then you have number of readers equal to 0 initially. Okay. Now this is the writer code, it's very simple. Same wait is equivalent to wait operation of the semaphore, right? Then so this is the count is the shared variable, right? The writer will just multiply it by 2. So that is basically, it is modifying this count variable. And at last we are printing the modified value. Writer, the number, since we have 5 writers, we will also print the writer number. and what is the count value after modification. And semaphore is equivalent of signal, semaphore signal. Now reader, if you see here, so this is the reader code. So reader, okay, I'm not going again through the, I'm making understand the logic since I discussed in pseudocode. It obtains the mutex, it increments the number of readers, right? If this is the first reader, it will block the writers, and otherwise it will, I mean, give the log away, perform the reading. So it will just perform the, it will read the, print the count variable, what is the value of count, and then reader will again acquire the log. It will decrement this, I'm saying exiting from this, it will decrement this. It will check if it is the last reader, then it will signal to the writer that you can go ahead with writing, and finally it will leave the log. This is the main function. This is also important. I have declared first p thread, so the reader writer threads. So I have here 10 reader threads and 5 writer threads. I have initialized the mutex and the semaphore also. So semaphore, this is a binary semaphore, so I have initialized to 1 here. And the second data that is passed as 0 is whether you want to share this semaphore with other threads or not, multiple threads or not. 0 means you want to. And this array just I've used for numbering the readers and writer. So you will see how I have used it. The first I am creating the 10 reader threads. So that you have to pass the readers, I'm thread names, and also the function that these threads will execute. And also I am passing a parameter, that is a number, I mean the thread number here. Similar with the writers. Then at last I am joining both these threads, because if you don't wait, wait on these threads, what can happen is so the main function is also a thread, right? So it can exit before this reader and writer threads. This is not the behavior we want, right? So we will wait for this and finally join both of threads. And finally we are going to destroy the, because these data structures, right? Mutex and semaphore, we have initialized on the heap. So we will destroy this before leaving. So I hope that you have, okay, now let's run the code. I hope you had understood the code. And if you have, also you can look at my blog for more information. And if you want to understand more about these functions, right? I've already told this is the link to, you should refer to for understanding this function. Now let's go and run this code. So we'll use GCC reader, and we'll also use a flag pthread. So you have to include this pthread flag because you are using pthread function library here. So okay, if you check here, you have a.out file, that is now, I mean the program is now compiled. I can run this program, a.out. Okay, here if you see, it is very sequential in nature. I mean in this output it can vary if you run it differently. But you see first reader came, the value was 1 initially, right? That's what I have said. Second reader also, third, fourth, till, I mean all the readers came and they saw the value as 1, and after all the readers were gone, I mean they have completed reading, then the writers got the chance and they started modifying the value from the first digit to multiply to 2, then 4, 8, 16, 32, right? Let's run this again. We should get some other output. No, okay, again we are getting same. Let's run again. Okay, no. No, I just want that writer, maybe it gets the chance first. No. Okay. Every time readers are getting the first chance. Okay, I think we got, okay. So this is very random actually. So what usually happens is if the first reader normally gets it, I mean it becomes hard for the other readers. If the readers keeps on getting the access, right, then the writers keep waiting and at last they are performing the write. But in this case, in this output you see, first reader 1 came, it read the value as 1, then the writer 1 came, it modified the value to 2, then again writer 2 came, it modified to 4. Now again reader 8 came and it read the value as 4, right? It will read 4. Why? Because reader 2 has modified it to 4. Now reader 5 came, all of these readers read those value to, okay, 4 till now. Okay, again it became sequentially, I mean all the readers were there, then again writing happened. But okay, this was better than the previous one in which all the readers completed first, then the writers. And yeah, mostly this will be the output, and you can increase the number of readers and writers. You will get more random output. So you can always make them, I mean, 15, 20, any numbers, and you will get. Okay. And also, and this is the code link here. I have shared. So if you go on this, I posted the same code on the GitHub. So you can look at this. And if you see the output here, which I have pasted, right? So, okay, I was lucky that I got this output. This is reader 1, 2, then we have writer 1, modify to 2, again reader, then again writer, again reader, right? So if you keep on running, I mean, dot select job many times, you may also get this type of outputs. Yeah, but I mean, it's in this output, you are better able to understand how the simulation goes on. First reader, writer, then reader, writer. If the simulation is like all the readers complete first and then writer, I mean, that does not look much good. It's also demonstrating this behavior only, the first reader writer solution, but the output is more uniform. Here the output is more random. Yeah. So that's all for this video. And if you have any doubts or if you have any questions on this, you can comment on either the video or you can also comment on the blog. I will attach the link of the blog in the description. Thank you.